वेलकम ऑल, टुडे स्टॉप ब्रेकिंग न्यूज़ विद गीतांजलि फ्रॉम बायन टाइम्स। YSRC चैलेंजेस TDP सुप्रीमो एन चंद्रबाबू नायडू टू प्रूव चार्जेस ऑन 108-104 व्हीकल्स। गवर्नमेंट चीफ वीप जी श्रीकांत रेड्डी हैज स्लैम्ड द TDP फॉर लेवलिंग एलिगेशंस ऑफ इरेगुलरिटीज इन द परचेस ऑफ 108 एंड 104 एम्बुलेंस व्हीकल्स। Addressing a press conference here on Wednesday, Srikant Reddy said TDP chief N. Chandrababu Naidu was maintaining a double standard by making false allegations against the government, while Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan-Mohan Reddy is reviving 108 and 104 ambulance services to save people's lives. Naidu is accusing the government by tagging corruption charges in the tender process. We have awarded the tenders as per norms and there is a judicial review as well in the process. Naidu should read the tender documents before making allegations and we are ready to discuss the issue, Srikant Reddy said. Challenging the TDP chief to prove his allegations, Srikant Reddy said Naidu cannot see the welfare measures being taken up by the government, which has spent ₹28,122 crore in the past 6 months towards public welfare despite losing revenue. COVID-19 tally surges past 16,000 in Andhra with 845 new cases in 24 hours, 5 more dying. The COVID-19 tally in Andhra Pradesh crossed the 16,000 mark on Thursday with 845 more cases recorded in the past 24 hours. The state tally now stands at 16,097. 5 more deaths took the toll to 197. Of the 845 cases reported, 812 are of people from the state, 29 from other states and 4 are foreign returnees. 4 districts of Anandpur, East Godavari, Guntur and Kadapa districts recorded more than 100 cases in a day. On the brighter side, 281 patients got discharged from hospitals after their recovery, taking the total number of those discharged in the state to 7,313. The number of active cases now stands at 8,856. Anandpur recorded the most number of cases with 134, followed by 122 in East Godavari, 104 in Guntur and 101 in Kadapa. In terms of tests conducted, 14,285 samples were tested in the 24 hours ending Thursday 9 a.m. The cumulative number of COVID-19 tests conducted in the state now stands at more than 9.32 lakh. The number of tests conducted per million population in the state stands at 17,467. Visakhapatnam coronavirus count set to surge past 1,000. Spike in Visakhapatnam COVID-19 count continued as 76 new cases were recorded in the district on Wednesday. As many as 76 cases, the highest single day spike till now, were reported for the second consecutive day. A total of 976 cases were registered in the district till now, said Andhra Medical College Principal and North Andhra COVID-19 Special Officer P.V. Sudhakar. There are 600 active cases in the district now. Of the total 976 cases, 371 persons were discharged from hospitals after their recovery. 5 persons died due to coronavirus in the district till now. The number of containment clusters increased to 167 with the addition of 18 more. There are 78 very active clusters and 89 active clusters in the district. The number of dormant clusters is 51, while 28 clusters were denotified. Addressing a review meeting on COVID-19, District Collector V. Vinay Chand directed officials to update online all the information of patients from samples collected at government and private hospitals on the same day. Full swing Andhra Pradesh High Court activity to stay off till July 13. With the rise in COVID-19 cases in the state, the judicial and administrative functioning of the High Court of Andhra Pradesh, State Legal Services Authority, High Court Legal Services Committee and Arbitration and Mediation Center has been suspended to July 13. As per a notification issued by the HC Registrar on Wednesday, only urgent matters will be heard via video conferencing. Filing of urgent guidelines issued by HC for e-filing and video conferencing will be followed for filing urgent cases. Filings via email will not be entertained, the registrar said. Hearings of urgent matters will be held from the official residences of judges through the BlueJeans video conferencing app or any other app approved by the court. Matters such as bail petitions, suspension of sentences, habeas corpus petitions, demolition or evictions from premises and dispossession from land will be treated as urgent matters. Pending matters too may be taken up if an application for urgent hearing is filed, depending on the nature of the case. Private medical colleges in Hyderabad to now admit COVID-19 patients. Telangana Health Minister Yattala Rajendra visited different hospitals attached to private medical colleges in and around Hyderabad to inspect the facilities available for treating COVID-19 patients. He told all the identified private medical colleges on Wednesday to start admitting COVID-19 patients and help the government in tackling the crisis. The government had taken a decision earlier in April of providing treatment to COVID-19 patients in private medical colleges free of cost. For this, around 22 private medical colleges having 10,000 beds have been identified across the state. Health department officials told Express that in some of these medical colleges in the districts, patients have already been admitted. The admission to these colleges will be based on reference by government healthcare centers. On Wednesday, Yattala inspector facilities at Kamineni Hospital, OYC Hospital, Malareddy Hospital and ESIC Hospital, Nacharam. Telangana recorded its highest single-day spike of 1,018 COVID-19 cases on Wednesday, when 7 patients succumbed to the virus, taking the total toll to 267 in the state. Wednesday's steep spike took the total number of positive cases in the state to 17,357 cases, of which 9,008 are active cases. Returning to US, an appeal task for H-1B visa holders in Telangana. Catching a Vande Bharat flight to the US with a valid H-1B visa has become quite troublesome for many Telanganites hoping to return to the promised land to resume work. Many people who are heading to the US on repatriation flights from Hyderabad had to face a volley of questions from immigration officials at Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad and Indira Gandhi International Airport at Delhi despite having valid H-1B visa status. A couple from Hyderabad who work in Seattle told Express, immigration officers told us that people with H-1B visas will not be allowed to fly as it has been suspended by the US administration. We had to update them that only the renewal and application of new visas have been suspended and that ours was an active H-1B visa. We had to face the same issue in Indira Gandhi International Airport and New Delhi. DPCC chief questions quality of irrigation projects in state. A day after a crack developed in the left canal of Kodapochamma Sagar flooding Venkatpur village in Siddipet district, DPCC president N. Uttam Kumar Reddy alleged that the government failed to maintain quality while completing the projects in the state. Uttam, who visited the affected village along with Congress MLC Jeevan Reddy and working president Ponnam Prabhakar, said, the breach in the Kodapochamma canal indicates to the quality of the projects in Telangana. The Nagarjuna Sagar canals were constructed several years ago with mud, but there have been no reports of any cracks or breaches till date. Though the Kodapochamma project canals were constructed with cement, we have already seen some breaches. This clearly shows what kind of quality was maintained in executing these projects. While stating that the Congress party is taking the issue very seriously, he demanded that Irrigation Department Chief Engineer C. Hariram be sacked with immediate effect. Bandi said to CM KCR to bring back stranded Telangana workers in Gulf. State BJP Chief and Karimnagar MP Bandi Sanjay Kumar, in a say to Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao on Thursday, urged him to arrange for those expatriates of Gulf countries wishing to return to Telangana. He said that the government shall arrange for bringing back at least 1,500 per day and of the central government. He said that there are 13 lakh workers in Gulf on any given day and out of that 25% would like to return home as they are either cheated by the travel agents or lost jobs due to COVID-19. Those who lost their jobs because of lockdown are in dire straits. They are living in miserable conditions, he said, adding that they are calling home pleading for help. He wanted that Chief Minister to assure their families of all possible help. He further said that the Union government is also ready to bring the stranded workers home. However, the state government must formally write to the centre and request them to arrange flights under Vande Bharat mission, he said. Telangana natives stuck in Iraq's Erbil due to COVID-19 lockdown demand flights home. Around 160 Telangana natives who have been stuck in Iraq's Erbil for the last 4 months recently garrowed the Consul General of India's office in Erbil after repeated assurances of the CGI on their return to India fell through. The group stormed the office demanding answers and alleged that while several flights were being arranged for natives of other Indian states, the same facility was not being extended to Telangana residents. The CGI had to call the Iraqi police to remove the protesters from the office premises. He has been a harrowing few months for Telangana natives in Erbil due to the lockdown. With no job, they were having trouble sustaining themselves. The situation also took on a toll on their health. When the Vande Bharat scheme was announced, they saw a glimmer of hope of returning to India. However, their hopes were short-lived as not a single flight for Telangana has been announced by Erbil till the date. Telugu actor Nitin to wed fiancée Shalini on July 26. The stage has been set for actor Nitin's wedding with his longtime girlfriend Shalini Kandakuri. The marriage, which was supposed to be held on April 16 in Dubai, was postponed due to coronavirus outbreak. According to a source, elders of both the families have now zeroed on July 26 as the big day for the lovebirds. The marriage, which will be held in Hyderabad on July 26, in the light of COVID-19 guidelines, it's going to be a low-key wedding in the presence of close friends and family members at a farmhouse. The wedding festivities will begin soon after Ashada Masam, informs the source. When Cinema Express reached out to Nitin's sister and producer Nikita Reddy for confirmation, she says the marriage date is not yet finalized and we will fix it soon. Last seen in Bhishma, Nitin is currently shooting for his upcoming films Rang De and Chek. He also has the Telugu remake of Andhadhun and a film with Chaitanya Krishna in the pipeline. With this, we conclude with our today's news headlines. For more such latest news and updates, like, share and subscribe by N Times.